Hi, I'm Pam, and I'm here to talk about retro video games. Today I'm talking about a game that pushed PC video game technology forward, increased the adoption of CD-ROM drives, and sold over 2 million copies. It's The Seventh Guest. The Seventh Guest was developed by Trilobyte and released for PC on April 1st, 1993. It's an adventure game that focuses almost entirely on puzzles and uses live-action video clips to tell the story as you progress. It opens with a lengthy scene which takes place in the past. It's 1935 and we're introduced to Henry Stoff, who is not a very nice guy. We see him murder a woman to steal her purse. That night, he dreams of a doll which he carves the next day. He's able to trade the doll for food and a place to stay. He soon dreams of more toys, each of which he creates, eventually becoming quite rich and building himself a creepy big mansion on the hill. But then, the children who have his toys begin dying of a mysterious illness, and Stoff retreats to his home and is not seen again. Until we find ourselves waking up inside his mansion. A series of ghostly visages appear, six guests who came to the mansion for a mysterious reason. That's when control is handed to the player. You can walk around and explore, though not everything is open to you from the beginning. You see things in first person from a series of fixed camera angles, and your movement from space to space is animated. As you explore each room, you'll find puzzles to solve. If you head to the library, you can solve a word puzzle by looking through a telescope. While if you head to the dining room, there's a geometry puzzle about cutting cake into equal pieces. As you solve these puzzles, more rooms will open up to you, and you'll see more scenes showing what happened to the mansion's guests. The Seventh Guest is notable for a number of reasons: the technology it used, the hype it created long before it released, and how well it sold. Bill Gates even referred to it as the new standard for interactive entertainment. The Seventh Guest wasn't the first PC game to be put on CD-ROM. That was The Manhole in 1989. Sierra had also worked on putting some of their existing floppy disk-based games on CD. But Seventh Guest was one of the first to release exclusively on CD-ROM and make the most of the benefits the format afforded. The way The Seventh Guest combined live-action clips using real actors with 3D rendered backgrounds was a novelty at this time, as was using a first-person view in an adventure game. The idea for The Seventh Guest was so unorthodox that when developers Rob Landeros and Graham Devine pitched the idea to Virgin Games, where they worked at the time, they were fired. President of Virgin Games Martin Alper thought Virgin's future was in cartridges. He wanted Landeros and Devine to make the game, but under their own banner, at an arm's length from Virgin, who would publish the title rather than develop it. It would be in development for 2 years, which was a pretty long time at this point. It started getting buzz fairly quickly. At the Consumer Electronics Show, crowds were compelled by the innovative appearance, turning what was supposed to be a small demonstration for Martin Alper into a much bigger showcase. They even managed to impress Roberta Williams from Sierra. Perhaps her 1995 game Phantasmagoria was inspired in some way by this demo. Virgin was so confident that The Seventh Guest would be successful that they got Trilobyte to start developing a sequel, The 11th Hour, before the first game even released. Their confidence was not misplaced. They initially shipped 60,000 copies, which sold out immediately. In its first year, it sold 450,000 copies, and by the year 2000, it had sold 2 million. Oh, and the price for the game was $100. That's a lot of money, especially in 1993. The cost of the game was not the biggest investment for players, though. At this point, not too many people had CD-ROM drives in their PCs, and they could cost hundreds to purchase. After the game released, some CD-ROM drive manufacturers claimed up to a 300% increase in sales. So The Seventh Guest, along with other games of 1993, like Myst and Star Wars Rebel Assault, really got the ball rolling on adoption of CD-ROM drives.
If you're anything like me, you might be wondering why this game wasn't on a console like the Sega CD. It seems like a perfect fit. Well, it's because Nintendo bought the rights to it. You know, for all those CD-based consoles it had in 1993. Just kidding, they bought it just so Sega couldn't have it.
So let's get to the game. How is it to play? The Seventh Guest has a very simple interface. You can do everything with just a click of the left mouse button. It was made this way to be as mass market as possible, something anyone could play. Animated icons appear on screen when you can interact with something. A beckoning skeleton hand will let you navigate through the house, a pulsating brain will appear when there's a puzzle to be solved, and a shifty eyeball will let you know what moves you can make during these. A 25th anniversary edition of the game was released in 2018, and it added a few quality of life changes to the game. The most useful is a map that lets you know what rooms have puzzles for you and which ones have already been solved. There's also a feature that lights up any areas of interaction on the screen. Otherwise, the gameplay is pretty much the same. At the start of the game, it's not really clear who you are or why you're here. Scenes you see will eventually reveal that all the guests were invited to the mansion to solve the same puzzles that you are. Thinking they'll be rewarded, they team up to work together, or, more likely, betray each other as the night wears on. Though this is set up to be a scary story, scares are hard to come by, and it's all rather tame. The acting is quite campy, which is probably for the best, since the quality of the video clips makes it difficult to make out anyone's facial expressions. The scenes individually can be fairly entertaining, though the overall story doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Audio quality of the voices and sound effects are quite good, and the music is well done. It was made by George the Fat Man Sanger, who also worked on the NES version of Maniac Mansion, Zombies Ate My Neighbors, and adapted Swan Lake for Loom. The soundtrack ranges from jazzy to spooky and takes on a funhouse quality at times.
While many of its technical aspects were impressive in 1993, now The Seventh Guest is a game that will live or die by its puzzles, and they're of variable quality.
Your enjoyment may vary depending on what kind of puzzles you like. I like math, logic, and word puzzles, while spatial or sliding tile and block puzzles make me want to tear my hair out. There are all types of puzzles here. The best ones have clear objectives. For example, one has you flipping a bunch of switches to get blood to pump through a tube without interruption, from a heart at the start to the end goal. Clear goals, clear rules. The tile-flipping puzzles, as much as I don't personally care for them, are also fairly straightforward in their objectives. But many are not so clear. One puzzle asks you to get from point A to point B while the tiles you step on fall away behind you. Even after solving this one, I really had no idea what made the solution the correct one. There's also a puzzle with knives near the end that gives no indication of what you're supposed to be doing. While you attempt to best each brain teaser, Stoff will taunt you, telling you that you'll never succeed.
Oh, I'm dying to see what you'll do next.
Your character will also speak, sometimes giving you clues about the nature of the puzzle. He also loves puns and alliteration.
A perplexing planetary poser. How puzzling. Perhaps a phonemic path can be phrased with a little postulation.
Clues can also be had from a book in the library. If you read it, you can get two hints for the puzzle you're working on. If you go in for a third hint, the puzzle will resolve itself, but you won't get to watch the cutscene you would have got if you had solved it.
My biggest issue is how repetitive things can get. In some cases, if you make a wrong move on a puzzle, you have to start again from the very beginning, and listen to all the same voice lines again. Some puzzles also have an excessive number of steps to solve them.
One of the worst cases of this was on a musical Simon Says type game, where you need to follow the keys you see pressed and press them in the same order. This went on for 18 rounds, and took 12 minutes of parroting back the key presses. Had I made a mistake on step 16 and had to go back to the beginning, I probably would have set my computer on fire. There are also some chess puzzles that require you to swap the places of black and white pieces, which is not really made clear, and one of these took 58 moves to complete. It's just a lot. My favorite puzzle took place in a microscope and was a game you played against an incredibly smart AI. The goal is to infect their pieces with yours and have the most tokens on the board at the end of the game. The internet has complained about this one a lot due to its difficulty, but it's the type of instant feedback, competitive game that will keep me trying for ages rather than look for a hint. One of the worst puzzles was a word one, asking you to make a sentence out of a jumble of letters which included 11 Y's. The sentence you had to make was incredibly dumb and unintuitive, though the hint book in this case was quite useful.
The Seventh Guest tends to get overshadowed by Myst when it comes to influential adventure games of 1993, though The Seventh Guest did come out first. Though it's not a game that holds up particularly well in the current day, it does have some challenging and enjoyable puzzles, and it really had a hand in pushing PC video game technology forward. It's worth a play for historical reasons, if nothing else.
Don't think you'll be so lucky next time!
If you want to see more, check out my review of another FMV horror adventure game, Phantasmagoria, or another of my videos. I also have a Patreon if you want to support what I'm doing on the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.